So students, let us go to our next theorem of this chapter, which is a very important theorem. It is Pythagoras theorem. I am damn sure it will come in the board examination. So our statement is, in a right triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square on the other two sides. So our proof is given in triangle ABC, angle A equal to 90 degree. To prove is AB square plus AC square equal to BC square. Construction, draw AD parallel to BC. Sorry, perpendicular. We can take this as perpendicular. So AD is perpendicular to BC means angle D equal to 90 degree. Okay. So our first statement is, compare triangle ABC and ABD. Angle B is common. Angle BAC equal to angle BDA, which is equal to 90 degree. Okay. Given angle BAC equal to 90 degree, by construction BDA equal to 90 degree. That is, given is angle A equal to 90 degree. That is BAC you can take or angle A you can take. I am taking BAC to be very easy to understand. So BAC equal to 90 degree. And now we took BDA as 90 degree. So this side is 90 degree means this side is 90 degree. Okay. So these two are 90 degree when we compare this triangle and the bigger one. Okay. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle ABD because two angles are equal. So we can write this is similar. Then we can write by Thales theorem AB by BD. Okay. Wow. AB by BD equal to BC by AB. Okay, that is, here you should not see this, but in diagram you can see that AB is the first is we should take the big triangle, no? So AB is the base. See this, AB is the base, and we should take the base of this triangle, this small triangle, which is BD. So what is the hypotenuse? Now you should take the hypotenuse, base and hypotenuse only you should take. So in this big triangle, hypotenuse is BC. Okay. So in this small triangle, hypotenuse is AB. So you can see. So that only I wrote here. Okay. So now you can cross multiply means this will become AB into AB, which is AB square equal to BD into BC. This is our first equation. Okay. This is very, very important. So learn it very. It is easy also, learn it very quickly. So now let us compare triangle ABC with ADC. Angle C is common, angle BAC equal to ADC equal to 90 degree. That is, now let us compare this triangle with the bigger triangle. Now we can see that both have C common. In the last time we had angle B as common. Okay, so this triangle also has B common and the bigger triangle also has B common. So in this side angle C is common. Okay. So next is angle BAC equal to angle ADC, you know, because it is both are 90 degree. So we can say these two triangles are similar, and we can say that we are taking now base and hypotenuse ratio. Okay. Now let us take BC, that is hypotenuse divided by the this hypotenuse AC. The small triangle's hypotenuse equal to AC, that is the height of the big triangle. Then you should take DC, which is the height of the small triangle. Okay. So you should not look like this. You should look like this, the small triangle. Okay. Which is DC is the height. Okay. So now if you write this, then we can write BC by AC equal to AC by DC. So when you cross multiply, you will get AC square equal to BC into DC. This is our second equation. By AA similarity, you know, angle. So angle and angle. Okay. So adding 1 and 2. So let us see what is 1 and 2 now. AB square equal to BC into BD. AC square equal to BC into DC. That is, I am writing it here. When we add it, we'll get if you have common thing, you'll take outside. So BC I'm taking outside, and inside you'll have BD plus DC. Okay. So from the diagram we should take. So here, what is BD plus DC? This big side BC. Okay. So now we can change this BD plus DC as BC. So which is BC into BC, BC square. Hence the theorem is proved. AB square plus AC square equal to BC square. It is very very easy. Learn it very. You can learn it quickly, but you should learn it. It is very very compulsory. Okay. So now let us see the converse of Pythagoras theorem. Just statement only you should write. Okay. No proof and a given construction and all. Okay. Only statement. So if the square of the longest side of a triangle is equal to the sums of the square of the other two sides, then the triangle is a right-angled triangle. That's it. You should just read this statement and you should be ready with the statement to write about converse of Pythagoras theorem. No proof, no given and all. Okay. So let us go to our next theorem. So angle segment, alternate segment theorem. Okay. So our statement is, if a line touches a circle and from the point of contact a chord is drawn, then the angles between the tangent and the chord are respectively equal to the angles in the corresponding angle. Alternate segments. So proof is given. A circle with center O, tangent AB touches the circle at P and PQ is a chord. S and T are two points on the circle in the opposite sides of chord PQ. So two proof is angle QPB equal to angle PSQ. Second part is QPA equal to PTQ. Construction is draw a diameter PQR, draw QR, QS and PS. So first, how to draw this, I'll tell you. Draw a circle, then keep a point P anywhere. Okay. So draw a tangent which is perpendicular to the diameter. Okay. You should draw a diameter, then it should be perpendicular to the tangent. Okay. That is, this angle should be 90 degree. Then you should draw a chord from this point of contact. That is from P, you should draw a chord anywhere. You can draw it here also, PQ. So then you should take two points in the opposite sides of the chord. That is in this major arc, you should take a point, and this minor arc, you should take the one point. So S and T, I'm taking here and here. Then I'll join SQ, QT, RQ and PQ. Okay, everything I'll join, I'll draw the diameter with center O. Okay, now let us start the proof. So our statement first is angle RPB equal to 90 degree. Now angle RPQ plus QPB equal to 90 degree. So because diameter RP is perpendicular to tangent AB. That is, so diameter is perpendicular to PR. So angle RPB equal to 90 degree, I told you. Then RPQ plus QPB. Okay. This angle plus this angle, same 90 degree only. Okay. So I'm just separating the 90 degree as two angles. Okay. Next is in triangle RPQ and PQR equal to 90 degree. Okay. In triangle RPQ, angle PQR equal to 90 degree because angle in the semicircle is 90. So in triangle RPQ, you know PQR is 90 degree. Angle in semicircle, you know, diameter separates a circle into two parts, so this is a semicircle. Then if you draw an angle with the two points of the diameter, then you will get 90 degree, you know, okay. So next is angle QRP plus RPQ equal to 90 degree, okay. Because in a right triangle, sum of the two acute angles is 90 degree. So now you got this triangle as 90 degree right angle because one angle is 90 degree. So by angle some property, you know, all three angles add up to 180 degree. Then if you add these two, you will get 180 minus 90, which is 90 only. Okay. Now you can see angle RPQ plus QPB equal to QRP plus RPQ. Okay. That is RPQ plus QPB equal to QRP plus RPQ. That is, you know, these two add up to 90 degree, then these two add up to 90 degree. So 90 equal means these two angles are, that is the pair of angles are equal. Okay. So that is, you can take the larger angles. So this, you know, it'll add up to QRP, and this, you know, it'll add up to PSQ. Because now only you saw that this angle is 90 degrees. So I'm taking, when you add it, we will get means. So we can take the bigger angle. So when you again add it, you will get 90 degree means we can take the bigger angle. So QPB equal to QRP, okay? That is QPB equal to QRP, that is QRP, okay? These two are equal angle, okay? Because you can cancel these two, because same angles, okay? You can cancel, this will go that side, mean it will become minus. So these two are equal. Let us take this as equation number 4. Then reason is from 1 and 3 you should write. So our fifth one is QRP equal to PSQ, because angles in the same segment are equal. That is, okay, this is a chord means this is a segment. So these two angles should be equal, these two. Okay. Then QPB equal to PSQ. So from 4 and 5. Okay. QPB equal to PSQ. That is 4 is QPB equal to QRP and 5 is QRP equal to PSQ. So you know QRP and QRP is same. So QPB equal to PSQ you can write. So this will be our equation number 6. Hence 1 is proved. So the first one you can see QPB equal to PSQ. Now we proved it now. Okay. So next is QPB plus QPA equal to 180 degree. That is this angle plus this whole angle is 180 degree. You know. Okay. So because they are linear pair of angles. Okay. So then again we can write the same thing. PSQ plus PTEQ equal to 180 degree. Okay. That is PSQ equal to PTQ. This angle and this angle is, when we add up, we'll get 180 degree, because sum of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Okay. So then QPB plus QPA equal to PSQ plus PTQ from 7 and 8. Okay. Now only we got 7 and 8. So you know. So QPB equal to PTQ. PSQ. Then you can cancel these two. Then you can write these two as equal. Okay. From 7 and 8. So then you can take. That is only done here. So you can cancel it here and here. Then you will get QPA equal to PTQ. QPA equal to PTQ. So hence 2 is proved. This completes the proof. That is 2 is QPA equal to PTQ. We proved it. So hence our proof is over.